Just a quick video for those of you dealing with hand stiffness, maybe the onset of arthritis, things like that. Just daily movement. Remember, what we want to do is, as long as we're not causing trauma, we want to retake space, or at least keep space from being taken. So space movement is all about space. It's about having the room to be able to move. And what arthritis does is it creeps in and takes up space. When it takes up space, then you don't have the room to move. So stiffness in the joints, things like that, becomes about being able to endure pain in order to keep space or regain space. So what happens is, usually when we have pain, we think, okay, I'm not going to move, and then we lose the space, then we lose the ability to move. So a lot of that has to do with the hands and being able to move in the hands, the wrists, and the forearms. So the dexterity, it's very important for me to maintain a dexterity in my fingers, in my hands, in my forearms because of the work that I do. Because of that, then I have a way to maintain my space. You, on the other hand, might not have that. You might not be doing a lot of things that forces you to have dexterity. So that means you've got to initiate the process. So we're just going to do some quick things here. Nothing's so accurate that you have to do it exactly like I'm doing it. I'm just wanting to show you some movements. The simple things are just taking the palms, putting them together, meeting the hands, and just dropping the hands, not allowing them to go like this, just dropping the hands down like this, and then turning them back and forth, just finding space, and you're gonna feel that through here. Same thing as if you push the fingers back and forth like that, just very simple, one at a time, pushing the fingers back and forth. And then what you can do is you can actually push down and then allow the fingers to come back, and then push back up, down and back. Those are simple ways to do it against the palms. You can do it against the wall, bringing the arm, the pit of the arm, the elbow up, and finding where we have that space. You can take it, turn it down, turn it to the side, move it back and forth, and you're going to feel that burning coming up and through. So you want to have as much movement so we can take these, we can wave our fingers at each other one at a time. What's going to happen is, as you do this, you're going to feel a lot of burning down and through, because we're not used to simply moving our fingers. So we can do all of them at once, grip them tight, turn like this, and then open them up and lay them out. Tight, and then open them up and lay them out. As you do these exercises, you're gonna feel a lot of burning down and through, but you're gaining space. So a couple of little more aggressive ones is, if you take your hands and put them out front like this, take the one and put it over the other, the thumb's pointing down, point the other thumb down, then grip the fingers together. Then take the hands and lay them open and get the elbows straight. Now, some of you might not be able to even get to here, but at least you can make the effort to be able to open those hands up. So when you come back, then you can take the other hand, put it over the top, grab these together like this, lay them open like that. And then that gets those forearms stretched. So finally, as much finger dexterity as possible, then wrist dexterity, and then you can even rotate. A lot of people like to use the figure eight, just a rotation of being able to turn and move. So that should help out a lot to try to keep those fingers mobile and moving.